Okay, let's get started. It's 3:04 here in Dubai. Good afternoon, everyone who's here in Dubai. Good morning and good evening, everyone. I know people are joining from various time zones. My name is Varun Malik. I'm the CEO of a new age consulting firm called Consolidon. New age in the sense that we don't hire a lot of consultants and put them on project. Instead, we partner with a lot of consulting firms and with boutiques to bring them in on projects. Connected Insights is a web summit that we've organized with about 70 boutique firms in our ecosystem and some larger consulting firms. We have here today Raj Vatikutti, who is the executive chairman of Altmetric. He's a serial entrepreneur, very passionate about helping businesses thrive in the digital era. And we're really, really honored to have you here with us, Raj. And looking forward to hearing from you on how digital business enablement can be done right in today's age. I'm going to hand over to Raj and Vipul. Vipul has joined from Altmetric as well. And I'm really, really looking forward to this talk.
Thanks, Arun. Really appreciate giving us the opportunity. And I think we really, truly believe the digital business is the way to grow the business. And main reason why we believe it is the best way to simplify and bring the collaboration across the organization. And so that you can really achieve the business outcomes, very much focused on everything about the growth. It is not a transformation. We truly believe it is a truly business by itself, digital business. And it has unlimited opportunity. It is not just for next 2 years, 3 years, it's forever. And that's the notion, the Altmetric, we started 7 or 8 years ago. And initially we had a very difficult time to convince the customers because they were so much bogged down with the current complex business and technologies, everything tried to do within that. And so it's disrupting the business and more taken as a technology approach than the really a business approach. And so that's why they spend a lot of money, especially large companies. Created, especially in the data area, created a lot of these data lakes. Unfortunately, now business feels that that information is not adequate for them to make the real decision and bring the business growth. And so mid-sized companies and small companies, they felt this is too expensive, too lengthy, and disrupt the current business. And they done experiment a few things here and there, but they never really took it serious. And then COVID-19 really woke them up because suddenly they're faced with a huge issue. They have no idea about what is going on in the business day to day, how much cash they have, how much inventory is sitting, what the supply chain issues, whole bunch of issues involved. And in the financial services industry, there's a lot of issues related to the risk and also opportunities. New opportunities in the payment methods and various areas. So initially we were very focused in the financial service companies because they were very much open to embrace the digital business aspect. We worked with the big time payment companies like MasterCard, PayPal, and Visa, and a lot of fintech companies, helping them to launch the new business models with our approach, the digital business approach. And one of the most strategic partners we worked with is PayPal. During this last 15 months, they've grown substantially. Their market value went from $100 billion to $300 billion in 15 months. And mainly because of they were able to launch a lot of the simple business models very quickly in the payment aspects of in the industry, became a very solid player. And like that, similarly, we worked within the banking industry, Citibank, Silicon Valley Bank, and DBS and a whole different bunch of them, mostly focused on helping them to simplifying the current platforms and modernizing to a certain level so that they can really achieve the business growth. And the whole approach they saw quite different from others. And this is where we're able to bring the business outcomes for them. Then we're heavily focused on the CPG, retail, pharma, and as well as the chemical industries, manufacturing and automotive. And CPG retail is probably one of the biggest problem they're really confronting today is about how much inventories they have, how much cash they have, and how do you effectively manage their the overall the marketing, sales, all those areas they were struggling through. So we help several CPG retail industry. We talk about some of those. And so I think the key here is to, everybody felt that this is very complex. It disrupts the current business. It's very expensive. And that's the notion we try to take it out of the market, mainly by focusing on more bite-sized approach rather than a big bang approach, saying that what five business challenges you're really facing today, how can we help you to take it one at a time quickly to simplify and really taking the approach of bringing the business outcome end-to-end collaborating and outside of the current business without disrupting that. That has helped the organizations achieve this with speed and the ability to bring the business outcomes. So that's the kind of approach we're taking and more proving. Last 2 years, we're getting a lot of traction with several companies ready to bring these kind of outcomes. And it's all about the discipline, culture of collaboration, simplifying, and also making sure effectively engaging it. So we truly believe in, unless you have at the CEO level really involved and making sure the business constituencies are collaborating with technology together, and then effectively engaging and focus on very much on the business outcome for growth. The growth is mainly look at the revenue, profit, market share, and cash. So if you don't, any of these outcomes, you do not tie to that, there's no point wasting your time. So digital business is all about the bringing the outcomes in terms of the growth. And so this is very important at the CEO level, setting the stage and bringing the culture together, and then having everybody collaborating across the company, the business, not only business, but the technologies together. In this process, we had to not only simplify and the technologies we had to do. As you know, especially large companies, technology is also very complex, a lot of silos all over the place, and making sure how we do this without getting into leveraging those assets already have into a digital platform, which can really simplify and create that kind of environment end-to-end, where effectively engaging the business and technology together. And this is where you bring the speed and you bring the, you can institutionalize across and get the scale over the time frame. We feel very confident for any organization based on the size and the issues they may have, probably anywhere from 1 to 2.5 years, we'll be able to achieve the roadmap in much bigger way for them to get there. By taking this kind of bite-sized approach, once the culture is created, we can do multiple initiatives together. And this is where I think it's really helped the large organizations to be have that kind of discipline. So so these are the basic way of addressing it. It's nothing rocket science. Simplification is the most important piece. That is, think out of the box of the current complex silos and the collaboration issues you may have today. And that's what we call single source of truth. Creating at every function across the functions is the key for the really bringing the effective outcomes. And the speed you bring it through, having end-to-end the kind of collaboration environment and technology by leveraging the existing assets already they have. And that's what really helps to making sure that there's not a big change aspect is involved. Change management is very minimal and to do this. But the key is to be at the CEO level, setting the stage, and this is the way we're going to go. This is the way we organize ourselves and creating that kind of culture, and CEO and the overall executive team staying on top of that, making sure these outcomes are coming effectively. Go to the next slide. So this is the approach we take. First is we sit down with the CEO level and the executive team. We prioritize what are the top five pain points you may have today. In generally, we see in the industry and CPG retail manufacturing, the major issue is the order management, demand management, inventory, supply chain, manufacturing, production planning. These are the basic things are there within that, which is really impacting them in terms of their business today. So some customers we've seen in the order management, we take it as a use case there. And as we've seen, some customers are really struggling with the inventories and in some issues with the manufacturing aspects of what they have. So really taking that, how do we, that pain point to simplify and really making sure that they're able to achieve that business outcome for the growth without disrupting the current business. So the second step we do is after that, we focus on each business function. Well, how do we create the single source of truth? This information is all over the place and many, maybe structured, unstructured, doesn't matter. How do we bring all that to one place and to work with the business, collaborate with them very closely in a very agile way so that they can see, clearly see this. And then so that not only purifying the data, bringing the right data together and giving them very effective insights so that they can make the decisions. And then after that, we apply the appropriate algorithms, which will give them better predictions on an ongoing basis. And this is, has to be not one time doing, this is ongoing basis, real-time data coming in and providing that kind of dashboards, insights to the business. At the same time, applying the algorithms and bringing that kind of single source of truth. But it's related to sales and marketing, it's related to order management, demand management, assort management, or the inventory management, supply chain, production planning, all those areas creating a single source of truth. So very well connected. So the finance team and the CEO can believe that they have the, they can proactively work on the business and help to bring the growth together. So the single source of truth is extremely important. And then the third piece is, how do we bring the innovation? How do we excite the entire organization, the innovation aspect, in terms of not only bringing the end-to-end, thinking of the new business models, experimentation is very important. It doesn't cost much. You're doing this experimentation based on the opportunity, then take that to the market, quickly productize into, take that to the market. This is a long-term continuous growth of the company. This is the kind of path that we work with the enterprises, whether it's a mid-size or large company. Mid-size companies convert very fast because they have no choice. They're really working towards that. And the large companies, to a certain extent, some areas they can converge, but slowly they're also coming together. Now we see in the last 2 years, so tremendous traction in terms of converging and thinking this way. And I think this is all about the simplification and the culture. So the next thing is, based on these pain points, we sit down, we will talk more in details about some of the use cases, about how we did this. The simplifying the pain points by working with the constituents that are involved in that pain point, and so that they can think outside of the current complex system. So that we also build a lot of data and analyze it and show them how this is effective, not having that kind of simplification. And so this is where they can clearly see, and they also can talk to their customers, see how it is affecting because of this. And so that bring the customers also together in this process and helping to simplify their pain points and try to make it more effective so that they can really conserve their cash appropriately and so that they can grow their business. And then the next thing is the we do is to making sure that, this, that the solutions we identify with the data and everything is quickly, because we're able to simplify it, and then it's outside of the existing business, and then quickly build these solutions in the platform, which I'll talk about in a little more detail. And so that you can really see the impact and the speed we bring in. These are anywhere from, based on the complexity of it, anywhere from 8 weeks to 16 weeks time frame, we try to bring these pain points together. And because through the simplification, having that kind of technology environment, we're able to do that. So in order to do that, we have what we call practitioners. We have a lot of practitioners in each industry who understand the business and technology, work with the business people, to help to simplify, then bring the very much truly agile product engineering oriented engineering teams, bring that together. So end to end, not only collaborating and actually ability to build a solution and launch the solution very effectively with speed. And this is where we're able to leverage outside of the current complex technologies. And so then we, in this, we also created a business, what we call a digital business platform, which is in the cloud, which is right from the idea to launch, totally connected and automated in all aspects of it. It has the security, the not only engineering, but also DevSecure operations are all connected very well. And so that we can bring the speed together. So every 2 weeks sprints or weekly sprints, which the business is involved, converging very fast. And then also have on a regular basis, management executive team, including CEOs involved, see how these are all coming together. So that not only solving the current pain point, creating the single source of truth across each function and across the company, and also start thinking about more innovation aspects of it so that they can really compete in this market. We've done this quite a bit with the fintech company, and they've been very successful in doing so, as well as in the CPG retail and also in the automotive industry. So with that, I will, if you have any, want some questions you want to ask now, or you want to do it later, fine, but the Vipul can take through some of the use cases for you to understand in more detail how it'll work.
Sure. Maybe we should just pause quickly for questions, if any. Give us a second. Any of the attendees, any questions? Sorry, we realize that we're just allowing you to talk if you have any questions. Vipul, why don't you go ahead and then we can ask questions in just a bit as well.
Sure, Arun. Am I audible?
Yes.
Yeah.
Thank you, Raj. And hi, my name is Vipul. I'm part of Altimetric and been through a great journey. The last slide, if you just go back to the last slide, Badri, for a minute. This journey of working through working with customers, understanding their pain points, and all the way to taking them through a journey where they see the outcome is very enriching for us as well as for the customer, right? And I use the word journey very specifically because these are not point in time solutions, right? As part of this, organizations realize how to look at a problem very differently, how to look at a working a process, technology, and people partnership. And that drives the solution, right? And as I go through some of the use cases, you will see a repeated pattern of people, process, and technology working together to actually solve the problem than it being a pure play technology solution, right? Technology, from an Altimetric perspective, we all strongly believe that technology is one of the tools which will solve your problem and not the tool that is going to solve the problem. And the bigger challenges are about bringing on board the ideas, bringing on board the people to actually be ready to solve the problem, fine-tuning your processes, which will help your organization to drive towards that solution. So on that, we'll go to the first use case. This is for a global apparel and fashion company. I will start with the end in view, right? Because that's very interesting in this engagement. Today, this company is number one apparel company by market value for lifestyle products, right? Across the globe. Now, when we started the engagement with them, they were not number one. And one of the things that they were striving or they were thinking that they want to achieve is to become number one, as well as to see what are the things that we need to do as an organization to drive that change. The second outcome of this engagement was the fashion industry is a very interesting industry, right? We as consumers go to a store, pick what is available in the store. We don't have an option. If you really think of it, consumers of the fashion industry go to a store, pick the whatever it has written as new arrivals or latest fashion, we tend to pick those things and wear because we believe that the new fashion. It's a very rare engagement where companies really get customer feedback, customer ideas to make their products, and then that I can wear. If Vipul likes a specific type of a shirt with specific length to the cuff and the button, I'm not going to get it until I go to a boutique tailor or someone who can do custom build for me. So this is another interesting area which this company wanted to invest in. They wanted to partner with their customers to build new products. And that's not easy considering fashion industries are generally a 2-year cycle, right? When I say 2-year cycle, the ideation starts, say, in 2018 for some product which would have got launched in 2020, or maybe at least some companies are a 1-year cycle. Except for few, one or two organizations, the general life cycle of a fashion to be on the store for us to be picked up is minimum 12 months. Now, this company wanted to change this. So these are long, big challenges, right? How do you change an organization to really convert their 2-year, 1-year cycle to a shorter life cycle? How do I talk to my customers to get this information, which can then become a co-creation for my customer? How do I, while doing all this, still achieve the number one, still grow my organization to the number one? So this is the outcome. How did we go about reaching this is a very interesting journey. So day one, we have this conversation directly with the CEO. Now, the very interesting point and key factor, you will see this repeating again and again in our all of our use cases, is the involvement of the CEO, involvement of the CXO level team in trying to solve a problem needs to be day in, day out, right? Organizations cannot define a problem or a solution space and wait till it is solved for them to come and validate. Leaders have to be part of the conversation every other week, every week if possible, to drive that conversation. That's been one of the key success factors that we have seen across all the use cases. So when we started, we had 3-4 conversations with the CEO, with the marketing team, and we figured out what is their problem statement, right? So we sort of simplified the problem statement by saying, you want to develop a product within the season. So if the spring season is running, you want to identify a product and then build, deliver it to the store within that season, aligning to the customer demand, right? So this 2-year, 1-year story is all the backlog which have, we have carried over the years. But what you really want is to do that. Do a fast production of an idea to product. You want to align your inventory to what customer needs. You don't want to dump inventory in the store, assuming customer will pick up. You want to dump products in the store, which customers will want to pick up. That's a very interesting difference in way you're looking at it. The third thing is you want to partner product co-creation. You want to partner with customers. How do you do it? You can get the customer feedback and do the product co-creation. So simplifying this target of becoming number one and trying to build what customer wants to very specific actionable pain points was very important, right? This is a very important aspect of our journey, Altimetrics journey and its success. Once you do that, then it's more about taking this out, identifying the key stakeholders in the organization, bringing the data from various touch points, bringing and creating a single source of truth. We are not talking about single source of truth from purely a data angle also. We are also talking about if a store manager has to look at a data, what is the store manager's single source of truth? What is a merchandiser's single source of truth? What is a product developer's single source of truth? So it's not only about data, it's more about process and where they're looking in. So we worked very closely with these different key stakeholders, built a system which consumes customer feedback in the store, in their e-commerce, in the social network, and divided or segmented by various attributes like color, fabric, texture, style, many other attributes to bring in a view to the product team saying, guys, your customers are today talking about a want of a product which looks like this. And that goes into the production cycle, which can create the production within the in season and then deliver it to the store. So this was one use case where if you really look at, there was a pain point, We simplified the pain point. We bring in the practitioner approach of bringing in the key stakeholders, iterative collaborative approach, and then using the platform to build these things faster, right? We used our in-house platform to bring the data to a common place, run analytics on top of it, build dashboards on top of it, and then take it to the outcome, desired outcome. And in this case, the desired outcome was little more than what we initially thought of. So that was a win-win for both the parties here. Moving on to the next use case, totally different world. This is a Hong Kong-based supply chain company. Challenges around cash flow, right? When you hear companies talking about challenges around cash flow, there can be any number of challenges inside the organization which you need to figure out or find out first. And again, going back to our principles of how do I simplify pain point? So when we looked and talked three, four conversations with the team, we figured out that their order management process is a manual and a complex problem. Now, how does that impact a cash flow problem? If I can process my orders in a timely, effective manner, my number of orders which I can process increases, which means my cash flow starts becoming more fluid than it being very systematic and cyclic or delayed or manual, right? So we figured out that the cash flow problem, one of the factors which feeds that is a complex order management process. We also understood that this company works with many customers on one end and many manufacturers on other end, and has an organic organization. It has grown to a point where there were multiple types of processes in the organization catering to almost similar activities, which attributes to an optimization issue. Can I create standard processes? Can I create standard formats which will reduce the load on my customers and which will reduce the load on myself as an organization, which will reduce the cost of executing an order? Again, driving towards a cash flow solution. Now, once we have solved or we have brought the pain points to a very simple, actionable solution point of view, again, it goes back to a practitioner approach. How do we collaborate, right? So we did not only talk to the CEO, CXO at this point, we also talked to the actual order taker who gets a call from the manufacturer saying, I need this order and this type of material. We sat with them, understood how do they do this? Why are they doing it manually? Why is one person not doing it like the other person? Why is one team not doing like the other team? And we figured out patterns, we figured out process challenges, and we also interestingly understood there are people challenges because these people have been working in this organization for decades. Now, if there is no customization to what they are doing, they have a fear of they becoming redundant or any process or a system taking over their job. That was very important for us to understand, because when you create a process which helps automate some of the aspects, we are not replacing people. We are actually giving them more time to do better things, right? So we also worked with the team, the actual order takers, the merchandisers, the technology team, and gave them the confidence that this is a tool. This process of automating your order management, the process of standardizing some of your business processes is a tool which will help you process more orders, or which will help you process, provide more value to the customers. The minute you can change the mindset of an organization and the people who are running the organization to that point, then it's more of a win-win point of view, right? So again, we used our platform that we have. We created data pipelines. We brought in the orders. Interestingly, this is a case where we have orders coming in different forms, right? I have a PDF, which is in I have three different PDFs, which comes for a single order in three different formats. And then I have Excel sheets coming in. Someone has written it on the phone call. They've written it on the sheet and then scanned it and uploaded it as an order. So an interesting technical challenge was to how do I convert this unstructured information into a structured information and then bring it into a system which can drive the process. And if you just think of it, many PDFs, handwritten phone calls tends to have manual issues, tends to have data issues. So we also build a data quality angle on top of it to standardize and find out quality issues and fix it automatically. all of this drives to the outcome. Now they have a standardized business process across organization. More than the company itself, the company's customers are seeing value that these guys are providing now, right? Due to this optimization, the orders are getting recorded faster. We are able to go back and fix some of the customer processes also, because now they are able to see, if this company has solved the process, why are we not able to fix our data? So that's another angle that we are driving. So we are not only fixed the core problem of our customer, we are also expanding this thinking into the ecosystem of our customer. And that's another interesting win, right? How one simplification of a process technology helps the whole ecosystem and not only the company. Key factor, the CEO, the presidents, everyone were involved at every stage of the engagement, right? And like Raj said, we don't go with a big bang approach. We sort of try to solve problems and have every 2 week cycle of showing some progress, right? Every 2 weeks we say, we have fixed this, we are going to fix this next week. And that cycle where a CEO also gets involved becomes very important, because they see the progress, team sees the progress, and the people on the floor started getting the confidence that my CEO is involved in fixing my optimization problem. That's a big win for an organization, change the dynamics of the organization. Moving on to the next use case. So just to reiterate, we talked about a garment company, we talked about a supply chain, and a different perspective. This is an ongoing engagement, right? This is currently, we are working on this engagement. So you will see out, instead of outcome, it's planned outcome. And some of the things are more on in progress activities, right? I have this and one more use case. So before I go there, I'll pause here for any questions. There's a lot of things that I've said. I've been 15, 20 minutes I've talked. So I'll open it for questions, specific questions. Other than asking me who the customer was, any other question I'll be able to answer. Silence means either you did not understand anything that I said, or you understood everything I said. And I'm sure you did not understand everything I said. Or if you guys are shy to ask over call, you can also type it in the chat. We have the team who will read the questions and or I can in fact read the questions and answer them. So I'll pause for 10 more seconds. If not, please start typing your questions in the chat. And we'll pick up the questions from the chat and answer those. Okay, one good news is after I said, if you have any questions, I didn't see any participants drop out. So which means until at least the content is good, only that you don't have a question. So let's go on to the...
At least they can say, well, the content is good.
Okay.
So somebody said, it's pretty clear, the illustrations. Okay, that's good.
Okay, so this, let's talk about this use case. Was there a question?
There's a question from Abhay. He's asking, what exactly were the solution components you used for the garment use case?
Okay, Abhay, if you are, let me break this into two parts, because the solution components can be in the technology side as well as on the process side. Technology side is a Google platform based solution. We used a lot of Google Analytics. We used Google translations, because the interesting part is this customer's stores are all across the world, right? Which means we had to convert the languages like Korea, Arabic, Hindi, Chinese, Japanese into a common language for the analytical engines to actually work. We have language native analytical engines, but they are not as robust or as mature as English language analytical engines. So we have to contextualize the translation first, run the analytics, and then provide the product insight. All of this was built on, I'm going to go a little bit deeper on the technology, Java, React, Google Analytics code, Google translation code, Kubernetes deployed on a Google Cloud. This is from a technology point of view. From a process point of view, we had to educate the storekeepers, store managers to collect this information. Now, if it's an e-commerce, that's a more of a pull model, right? All you do is give them an interface and some customer is entering that information. But how do you collect this information in the store? So we actually had the team a mobile app where it also had a recorder. It also had quick data entry options where a store manager, so if I'm walking into the store, trying out a shirt and then did not want the shirt, immediately a question is asked, why do you don't want this shirt? Now I give some answer. That answer is recorded, which means you understand the feedback of the customer. Or at the checkout, people say, why did you select this shirt? Why did you like this shirt? So all this was a more of a process people change that we had to work with the customers to implement, is to educate all the 6,000, 7,000 employees at the store to give and collect this information. So did I answer your question? I know the question.
I think one more thing, Vipul, I want to add about 3,500 stores around the globe and the various languages. I think the most important thing is we found is the actually sentiments. You know, typical Google analytics or algorithms or Watson, they were not able to recognize some of the sentiments. So we had to build our own algorithms to really, for this particular industry, to make sure the sentiments are very appropriate so that the merchandising team and the design team really understood very well. So that was a very important piece where we have brought in. Now we also looking at these things expanding to not only voice of customer, voice of anything we can do. So there's a kind of, over the time, we're building a pointed solution for the industry to help to these kind of sentiments, very specific to that particular industry.
Thank you, Raj. Yes.
All right. Thank you. I think that answered my question. And just a final question on this. So what you said, Raj, is very important. It was capturing the sentiment and all the unstructured data, which is so important in this kind of process. So that's useful. So this, just a quick question. Again, I come from a sales perspective, so pardon if it sounds ignorant, but this whole solution, from what I understood, is there was no integration with any backend system like SAP S/4HANA or, you know, the system of record, right? This is more of a proactive customer engagement and process improvement front-end kind of system, am I right?
So we do have integration touch points from a master data, from a process angle, from cataloging information. It's when someone says white polo shirt, right? How do you connect it to which material is it, which style we are talking about? So there was integration to their existing ERP, but this solution is sitting outside the existing ERP, providing them the actual problem statement or solution space, right? So integrations are always required because many companies have invested that time and some of the information sits there, though many companies have not really used its fullest potential.
Yeah, that answers my question. Thank you.
Also, here we've taken these things from the e-commerce, the call centers, the information, social media. So a lot of integration went in. But in generally, what we do, these solutions, we do outside of the current complex systems, especially ERP takes so much effort to do. Yes. So we bring the data from the ERP systems, so we bring it from the CRM systems, you name it, across. We, our platform, it has a standard APIs, open APIs, will go to fetch the data from various sources, connect them, purify the data, and then create the dashboards, and then also do the overall applying the algorithms. So that's where we bring the speed together so that you're not bogged down with the current complex systems.
Great. Thank you.
Okay. Thank you, Abhay. Moving on to this use case about a global chocolate manufacturer. So it's very interesting, right? The first call we had with the chairman of the organization, the CEO, the call was more towards a problem statement, which was like this. We do not have visibility on the inventory in the store, one liner, right? And then it goes, it followed by giving a use case of in a specific city, four blocks away, there are two stores. One store had surplus inventory, the other store ran out of inventory. We did not have the visibility to do the inventory move from a store to another store for it to be sold. This is a very simple one-liner statement at the chairman CEO, right? But when we started the conversation, in the next third conversation, we figured out that this company is it's an artisan company, a chocolate manufacturer, which means they have siloed way of building chocolates. In fact, they had multiple factories not talking to each other, and a specific style item or a product ID in Europe was totally different than what it was in US. For example, an almond roasted almond coated with white chocolate and a brown chocolate meant totally different in the world of Europe and meant different in the US, though it actually were exactly the same chocolates, same products, which means at a data level, we understood that they do not have a centralized product master, right? If you don't have a centralized product master and you want to run a global organization, it creates a lot of challenges, and it obviously will create a challenge of sharing inventory or optimizing your inventory. So we simplified the problem saying, currently you don't have a product master. So that's something that we need to have. Now you have an inventory information. If you go to the American stores, you do have the inventory information there. If you go to Europe, you have inventory information, but there's no sharing of this information. So it's more about not that we don't have information, it's more about how do we share this information. Now, this also led to another interesting point of order processing, right? If a store already has surplus and another store does not have, which means when I was doing order processing, I have not clearly forecasted the demand at a store level, which means it's not only an inventory issue, there is a challenge at your order processing, which the teams are not talking to each other, and hence there are challenges in terms of catering to these stores. So we broke it down to very specific action items. So let's start building the product master first, because that's the base layer. That's your foundational layer, right? Once you do that, then we'll create a inventory reporting. We are not talking here about inventory management system, right? That's something that ERPs come and give you, right? That we'll reach there, but first let's have a report. What is that information that we have? Where do I store? Where do I take? That information is what we need to collect. And in due course of that, we will also understand what are the order processing challenges and put a roadmap for it. The team is currently working on it. We are in the third sprint. We in fact had, so every sprint we have a demo with the CEO. We walk through what we have done. Raj is also involved every sprint. I mean, it's when I say CEO, it's at the both ends, right? Our CEO gets involved, customer CEO gets involved. It's not a project which is given to someone to execute. It's a project which these leaders want to accomplish. It's a problem or a solution space that they want to be involved to solve. And that involvement is again very important in all our engagements, right? We are using our platform to bring define the master data, define all this information, bring it to a single source of truth concept. We are going to standardize the data across the globe. We are going to create a central inventory monitoring system, which will help them to understand where there are inventories and see if they can create optimization towards it. And at the end, we are also planning to give, we are trying to now go beyond the problem set of solution space to see if we can also give some product insights, right? Maybe this company, this city likes this type of chocolates based on the amount of sales you have done. So we are seeing if we can take them to that next level of forecasting new products also. So this is again a totally different pain point which started. We simplified the pain point, and then we are currently in the practitioner point and the solution space. And we will be finishing this in a 11 sprint cycle, where at the end of 11 sprints, they would have solution for all of these things. And one important thing is all of our solutions are not something that you wait for the end of the season. And this is very important for everyone who is listening in. Let us not get into conversations which are multi-year, and at the end of multi-year, you get a result. The conversation should be directionally. We know that at the end of 1 or 2 years, this is where we want to reach. But what are we going to see next week? What is the next progress we are going to see? How is it going to help me today? And are we ready to pivot if the system pivots? Right? Many companies before COVID 2019, they had this multi-year engagements, which actually have got killed now because they were not ready to pivot when a big thing like COVID hit us. Right? And that ability to iterate, ability to be flexible in developing what you're developing is very important for any engagement to be successful.
One of the most important thing is we really come as a catalyst. We're not a consulting or outsourcing company. We're very focused on the outcome, working with the customer, making them walk, making them to crawl, walk, and run. That's our goal, to make sure that they really take this and run it there. We're all we are there is a catalyst to help them to start thinking that way.
Thank you, Raj. Moving on to the next slide, Badri. We also wanted to present to you a very interesting tech use case, right? We talked about business use case. So obviously there'll be some people in this call who are like, okay, these are all business challenges. Talk to me about a tech challenge. So we wanted to present one of the interesting tech challenge here. This is a well-known company who wanted to move away from being a car manufacturer to becoming an urban connectivity leader. Now that's a huge shift for companies, right? So we are talking about, say, I'm going to take a context of India for a benefit of not exposing the actual customer. So if Tata says, I want to stop building cars and I want to become the connectivity leader, which means I will invest in roads, I will invest in infrastructure for the mobility sector. I'll invest in digital applications which will help people move. I will invest time and effort to help people move from point A to point B than building an equipment for that. Right? It's a huge mind shift, right? And one of the tech challenges of that was how do they connect to the customers at the technology level? And technology is very important. When you want to become an urban connectivity leader, and urban the population in an urban city is primarily connected through digital, be it your success stories of Uber or Ola or other mobility engagements that we are seeing today. This company wanted to get into that zone, right? How do they help customers connect to their vehicle in a way that is very different? And every vehicle nowadays, at least last couple of years, you would have seen the trend that you can start your car through your phone and stuff like that. This company wanted to go a step beyond. The minute Apple Watch launched, they wanted to say that I want my customers to be able to start my car, my vehicle, through any form factor, right? And that was the high level problem statement. So we worked with them. We understood their current native app had limited customer conveniences. They did not have a connection for any form factor. They had very bespoke solutions for if it is iOS, if it is Android, and so forth. And some of these bespoke technologies innovations are impacting long-term plan. They needed to build something which is generic enough to cater to multiple form factors. So we had a design team from our side who worked with the native iOS team, who worked with the Apple as an organization, as a team. We worked with the customer and their technology team to standardize what are the customer experiences that we can provide, which can span across multiple form factors. So tomorrow, if someone, headphones, the iPods which are coming, or the digital headphones which have a small screen and it can sense your finger movement, can what we solve now, can it be carried over to the next form factor? Can it be carried to the intelligent spectacles which are coming out nowadays? So that was the engagement here. So we created a very simple use case where it had very minimal activities, or very critical minimal activities, like start, stop, how much time it needs to be start, in AC and stuff, basic stuff for the vehicle level. Very short end-to-end development, 6 weeks, we were able to complete this. This concept or this use case is more about talking about speed and the technology aspect of it, where we are working on a cutting edge technology like an Apple Watch connecting to an IoT device in your car through a server, and then also being able to complete it in a very short span of time. So that's on the pure play tech use case that we wanted to present, where it also showcases the same principles of how do you simplify your problem statement? How do you simplify your pain points? how do you bring in a practitioner approach, how do you use a platform to solve it, and how it drives your solutions in an iterative short, in an iterative manner, in a short cycle. That's pretty much end of what I wanted to speak. There are 7 minutes.
So this mainly illustrates the innovation, how fast we could create a proof of concept and productize at the same time. Is really proven now. More and more, they are taking this kind of approach, experimentation, and what things have the business relevance, then take that to the market and productize it. So it's everything taking the product engineering approach. It's not just an app development.
Raj, do you want to give any final notes? After that, we can open up for questions.
No, I think I think we are very excited how the business are converging, thinking through this. I feel next 5-10 years, this is the way our business will be start moving. And simplification is the most important piece. And then the collaboration and effective engagement. For our own, we're also doing for ourselves. We want to make sure all our employees engage real time within all aspects. And they're also help to bring the innovation for us to create these customer solutions, evangelizing these things and the culture. And so we're very excited this thing. For me, this is the technology world. First one was the IT, that was a different landscape. Now this is really I'm enjoying, and my teams are doing a phenomenal job bringing these solutions very quickly. And any help, any of you want to anytime talk or really want to brainstorm, we're very glad to help you on this aspect. Thank you again, Varun, for giving us the opportunity.
Not a problem, Raj. It was our pleasure.
Any questions you have? I think we have another 5 minutes.
Yeah. And in the meantime, you know, what we like to do is we like to take a photo of everyone in the panel. So if everyone just humors me for a minute, you can ask questions while you're waiting. We'll make you all panelists. You can switch on your videos you know, fix your hair, and we can take a quick photo. Just give us 1 second.
Yeah, sure. I don't have a hair, so I don't know how to fix it.
Well, lucky you. Great problem to have, Raj. Great problem to have.
I have unfixable hair.
That's awesome.
Raj, it's very early there. It's like probably 8 a.m. now.
Yeah, that's no problem. Really, no problem. Thank you. Okay. Anybody else has any other questions?
Yeah.
Thanks again, Varun. Hopefully, we can touch. Hi, Ranga. So, look forward to working with all of you. Thank you.
Thank you so much, everyone.
Yeah.
Thank you very much.